So no matter if you're doing a remote video podcast or wanna stream a video conference of any kind to YouTube, Twitch, Facebook or any other platform, you've come to the right place. My name is Franz and I'm gonna show you three different approaches on how to live stream your video conference for free. Don't forget to like this video and consider subscribing for more content creation tips on the cheap. First of all, here is my best advice right up front. If your video call doesn't need to be broadcasted live, don't do it. Live streams tend to be a constant supply for tiny little problems which you can easily avoid. Here's what you do. Get all participants together in a group call. Let everybody record their video and audio track locally during the recording. Make sure to create a sync point, like all clapping at the same time. After the recording, gather all files using something like file mail, which supports uploads for up to 50 gigabytes. Sync everything in your preferred video editor. Create a multicam edit, you're done. In almost every case, this will have the highest quality possible and gives you more flexibility in post-production. This approach is best for a small number of people in the call, for example, for podcasts with a regular crew. If you have more guests, don't trust yourself or your guests with these technical responsibilities or just need to be live, then check out the following approaches. Number one, the easy way. This entails using a service that does everything for you. You and all your guests get into a room. You press broadcast live and you're done. Fun times, but for the best broadcast possible, everybody needs to do their part and get their priorities straight. So this is for you and your guests. The most important thing is audio. If the video is bad but the audio acceptable, the viewer may stay, but the other way around, no chance. So use the best microphone already available to you in a quiet room. Oftentimes your phone's headset will do just fine. Then make sure your face is well lit. Sitting in front of a window is a great no budget softbox. The better the light, the better the image, no matter the camera. Which is the last thing to consider. In camera, get your framing right. And please, don't be the one guy in a video call whose video is vertical. There are different platforms that will broadcast your video conference. All have their advantages and disadvantages. Most services have a free plan, but will often include a watermark. In my testing, I like StreamYard.com because there you can manually switch between different people and it's very easy for guests to join. If you want something that automatically switches to the person speaking, check out Jitsi Meet if you can stand the black dissolve transitions. The advantages of approach number one are: it's very easy to set up and no powerful PC is needed. The disadvantage include that you have no control over quality in video and audio, and the broadcasts without watermarks are usually not free. Number two, the intermediate way. Now we will use a live streaming software like OBS. Get in a video call on a platform of your choosing. Add a window or screen source to your OBS scene and adjust everything as you wish. If you want to have everybody next to each other, use services like Discord, Skype or Zoom. For automatic switching to the active speaker, again, use Jitsi Meet. In some situations, you, the one that streams, want to have two instances running of the video call service. One for yourself, so you can participate in the call, and the other should only act as a spectator for capturing. If you want to be a real gangster, you can even hide unnecessary elements with developer tools or add the Jitsi Meet URL as browser source into OBS. With some simple CSS statements or URL parameters, you'll have a clean feed of the conference. If you opt for adding your own camera in OBS directly instead of the video call, but still want to appear there, you will need some kind of a webcam splitter software, as sometimes you can't use a webcam in two programs at the same time. The advantages of approach number two are: you get lots of control, for example, how the scene looks, the resolution, the frame rate, and get access to audio and video filters. This is the best approach for lots of people in the call, if the service supports it. The disadvantages are that you need a decent PC and internet that both can handle streaming, and of course you need some knowledge about streaming. Number three, the hard way. If you want to have the highest quality possible in video and audio, then you need to have full manual control, like having individual video streams of participants and switching between them as you wish. Also, I recommend handling audio and video separately. Remember, audio is more important than video. So, for example, use a service like cleanfeed.net to bring a high quality audio stream of all your guests into OBS. To get your guests as true separate video sources into OBS, you have three options at the moment. Option A, use Skype in conjunction with NDI. Get everybody into a Skype group call, and with the OBS NDI plugin installed, you add every participant as their own video source. Downsides are the always visible Skype watermark and that you can only work with the quality that Skype transmits. Option B, for full control, let every guest go to OBS.Ninja and go to the Add Your Camera to OBS button, not the group video one. They shall select the resolution, the camera, and no audio. After that, they can send you the link from the top of the page, which you can then import as a browser source into OBS. With URL parameters, you can change the video encoder and even the bitrate. So when importing into OBS, you decide with what bitrate the guest is gonna send over his video stream directly to you via P2P. So if you and your guest all have good internet connections, you can have very high quality video tracks in OBS. If you and your guests also want to see each other, I recommend outputting the OBS scene to a virtual webcam and make it also available to everybody via OBS.Ninja or a different service. The downsides to working with OBS.Ninja are you're gonna need a very good internet connection and test everything extensively beforehand to make sure you don't end up with choppy videos because somebody's internet in the call can't handle it. Option C, and this is my favorite method. Get all together in a Jitsi Meet room. For every participant you want as a separate video track, you will add a new browser source with the conference URL. With a way too long list of parameters, you can set preferred resolution and hide unnecessary icons and even the watermark. With some additional CSS, you can also get rid of the filmstrip view. Now, interact with the browser source. Press a number on your keyboard to switch to the person you want as a single video stream. While you sacrifice some control in comparison to OBS.Ninja, you gain the fact that your guests find themselves in the usual user-friendly interface of Jitsi Meet, while you get to play directly. The general advantages of approach number three. You get the most control over every aspect of the broadcast and therefore ensure the highest quality possible. The clear disadvantages are that this is technically very demanding, both hardware and knowledge-wise, and it's not really practical for lots of people in the call, let's say like more than four. So, too long, didn't watch, and to summarize. If you need something easy to set up, use StreamYard.com or Jitsi Meet and stream directly from their website. If you want to have some control over your broadcast, use OBS and capture within a video call service of your choosing. If you want to have full control, the highest quality possible, and have the hardware for it, check out OBS.Ninja or get creative with Jitsi Meet. So tell me in the comments, what will you end up using, and also send links of some results if you want. If you have any other solutions in mind or experience with, please let everybody know. Subscribe!